Okay, so last time we have started with the elements of weather and climate, and as we have seen that the weather and climate is one of the very very important particles of the phenomena which takes place in the atmosphere, especially in the lower atmosphere, that is in the troposphere. So we have started with the discussion about the factors responsible for the distribution of temperature over the surface of the earth, right? So we have discussed about two factors, in fact three factors, which influences the distribution of the temperature on the surface of the earth, right? So can anybody tell me which are those three factors which decides the distribution of the temperature on the surface of the earth? Yes, so can anybody tell me? Yes, Tarannum, what are those three factors which decides the distribution of the temperature on the surface of the earth? Am I audible to all of you?
So latitude.
Latitude.
Also the altitude.
Altitude. Okay. And third factor. Yes, Ritika, you are not audible to me. I guess there is some network issue. Can you please repeat it again?
So latitude, longitude, altitude, and the movement of the Earth.
Movement of
around
the
Sun.
Orbit. Okay. So the revolution of the Earth decides the season. I'm talking about the temperature. So the first factor is latitude. You are right. Altitude is also right. The third factor is called continentality, or the distance from the sea. Like whether that place is located away from the coast or it is located at the middle of the continents. And depending upon that, the temperature of one particular region is also decided. So I just want a brief explanation from you that how these three factors influences the temperature. Yes. Can you explain me, Ritika, that how latitude decides the temperature of any one particular region?
Yes, sir. So basically, so the sun rays moves from south to north and north to south due to rotation, the temperature of the place. And as we know, due to the altitude, 6.4 degree centigrade, there's a difference in every 1 kilometer. So in that way, as the density of the gases lowers down and the greenhouse effect does not work. So that, that is how the temperature decreases. And in the coast and the sea also, due to the land breeze and the sea breeze, the coastal areas, basically they have a moderate temperature, but in the land, they have the heat is more faster and the cooling process is also faster.
So in the continental area, that is in the middle of the continent, so the temperature is more at the coastal region or the temperature is more at the continental region?
Temperature is more at the continental regions.
In summer. Right, it depends. Actually, it depends upon the season. So, if it is summer, the temperature is more in the middle of the continent and or you can say less at the coastal region. And during winter, it is exactly opposite. The temperature is more at the coastal region and temperature is very low in the middle of the continent. Right?
Yes.
And so all that we have discussed last time, right? And latitude-wise, also we have discussed that latitude-wise. As we move upward, that is in the higher latitude, the temperature is low, and in the middle latitude, the temperature is again low, and in the latitude at the equator, the temperature is high. Got it? So we are discussing about that. What are the factors affecting the temperature of the distribution? Can you all see the screen? Is it visible to all of you? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so here you can see that the temperature of air at every place is influenced by one is the latitude, then altitude, and distance from the sea that we have discussed. Now we will also discuss about that the presence of warm and cold ocean currents. Now before understanding that what are these, like how the warm and cold ocean currents influence the temperature, first we need to study what are ocean currents. So this particular aspect of influence of the warm and cold ocean currents, we will discuss later on. Like when I will be discussing the oceans, at that time I will discuss with you that how the warm and cold ocean current influences the temperature of any one particular region. That I will be discussing while discussing the ocean currents. Now moving on to the next important what you can say, the factor which impact which influences the temperature, that is called as the local aspects. Local aspects means that we can see that local aspects, like for example, sometimes what you can say, suppose if the sun is on the southern side in a mountain region, and if the sunrays are falling on the southern side, and if there is no sunrise falling on the northern side of the mountain, like because of the mountainous region, then obviously the temperature will be more at the southern side of the mountain and compared to the northern side of the mountain, because the sunrays are not directly falling on the sunrise. This happens especially when the mountains are located west to east direction, and not north to south direction, but west to east direction it is located. Then northern side the temperature is high, sorry, low, and the southern side the temperature is high. So that is what you can say, that is how the temperature of any one particular is decided, right? Now going to the next very very important, what you can say, the aspect of the element of the weather apart from what you can say temperature is called as, what you can say, the air pressure, right? So air pressure again directly depends upon what you can say, the temperature, because here we need to know about the what you can say about the relation between the temperature and pressure. So can anybody tell me what is the difference between the temperature and pressure? Anyone knows what is the relation between temperature and pressure? Temperature is more, pressure is high or not?
Pressure is low, sir.
Yes.
If temperature is more.
So if temperature is high, then pressure is what? The pressure is low. And if the pressure is, if the temperature is low, the pressure is high, right? So as we have seen that at the equatorial region, the temperature is low, the temperature is high. And at the polar region, the temperature is low. So two types of pressure belts are created at the equator and at the polar region. So depending upon that, depending upon the pressure belts, the winds are also circulated. So winds blows from high pressure belt to low pressure region, right? So here there is one video which I will be showing to you, that how the pressure belt over the globe, like over the surface of the earth, what you can see, are created, and how these pressure belts leads to various types of winds on the surface of the earth that you need to understand. So first you watch this video, and then I'll explain this to you, that how the pressure belts are created, and what are the various types of pressure belts, and how these pressure belts influences the temperature, as well as the third important factor, that is rainfall. So just give me a minute, I will be sharing this video too. So please first watch this video, then I'll explain this to you. So there are how many pressure belts and how the pressure belts are created.
In this video, we shall learn about the various pressure belts and wind patterns that have developed on planet Earth. While understanding the basic concepts behind.
Now, can you all see the screen now here? Is it visible to all of you?
Yes.
Okay. So here you can see that we have already seen that the temperature distribution on the surface of the earth is like, at the equator, the temperature is very high. At the polar region, the temperature is very low. So at the equatorial region, due to the very high temperature at the equator, there is a creation of a equatorial low pressure belt. So a low pressure is created here because of the high temperature, right? And again, you can see that here at the polar region, since there is a low temperature, there is a creation of what? There is a creation of a high pressure belt. So wind always blow from high pressure region to low pressure region. So obviously here you can see that here there is an equatorial low pressure belt, and here there is a subtropical high pressure belt. Since we know the temperature of this region and the temperature of this region is different, so here the temperature is low and here the temperature is high. So wind will blow from subtropical high pressure region to equatorial low pressure region, and it will move upwards and it will subside down. So here there is a creation of a, what you can say, a pressure cell. So the wind will blow from subtropical high pressure belt. The red one is the high pressure belt and the yellow one is the low pressure belt. So here the wind will blow from this region to this region. It will move upwards, it will come down. Same thing will happen in the south hemisphere also. We have discussed that below the equator there is south hemisphere, and above the equator there is north hemisphere. The same, the wind will also blow from equatorial high pressure belt to subtropical, subtropical high pressure belt to equatorial low pressure belt. So here two pressure, what you can say, the cells are created. So can you see here?
Development of pressure belts. We will not take it.
Okay. So have you seen? So there are various types of pressure belts created on the surface of the earth. So first watch this video, I'll explain this to you.
Into consideration the tilt of the axis and the influence of land water distribution. Equator divides the globe into southern hemisphere and northern hemisphere, and equatorial belt extend up to 5 degree north and 5 degree south. Equatorial region receives nearly vertical rays of the sun, and this heats up the air near the equator. When temperature increases, pressure decreases. So along the equator we have low pressure, and we call this region as equatorial low pressure belt. The warm air starts rising up in the troposphere, and as the warm air is rising, the temperature drops. After rising up to a certain point, it stops rising upwards because it becomes cooler and it is obstructed by tropopause. So the air spreads out. The air starts moving in the southern and northern direction. As the air is moving, it becomes denser, and after a certain point, it sinks down to the surface. So at around 30 degrees north and south, we have sinking air. This sinking air is cool air, so it forms high pressure systems. These regions are called as subtropical high pressure belts because these regions lie outside the tropical region and at the same time adjoining the tropical region. The sinking air now moves towards north and south. So along the equator, the warm air rises, spreads out, and cools and sinks down. In this way, it develops convectional currents. At the poles, the sun rays are very much inclined. So we have cold air that sinks. These regions are known as polar heights. In the northern hemisphere, the air moves towards the south, and in the southern hemisphere, the air moves towards north. At this point, we have air coming from north and south. So, at this point, the air converges and rises up. These regions are known as subpolar lows. So, at 60 degree latitudes, we have low pressure system because we have rising air. Along the equator, the air is rising because of convection, and at subpolar lows, we have rising air because of convergence. This rising air also spreads out, cools, and sinks. Same things happen in the southern hemisphere. On the surface of the earth, along the equator, the winds move from high pressure regions to low pressure regions, that is from subtropical highs to the equatorial low in the northern and southern hemisphere. These winds bend to the right in the northern hemisphere, and in the southern hemisphere, the winds bend to the left. And this is described as Coriolis effect. The winds bend to the right and left in the northern and southern hemisphere respectively, because the earth is spherical in shape and the earth rotates from west to east. In the same way, in between 30 and 60 degrees north and south, the wind bends towards right and left in the northern and southern hemispheres respectively. Even at the polar region, the same phenomena can be seen.
Okay, so have you understood how the pressure belts are created and how this pressure belt leads to what you can say, leads to beginning or initiation of the winds on the surface of the earth. Am I audible to all of you? Now here you can see, okay. Now coming back to this particular image. So here that you can see, now here you can see at the equator, there is a creation of the low pressure belt. And here at the subpolar region, at the subtropical region, this is called a subtropical region. Here there is a creation of the high pressure belt, right? So the wind blows from high pressure region to low pressure region. So here you can see the wind is coming from what you can say north to south, and here the wind is moving from south to north, right? So these pressure belts which are created at the equatorial region and the pressure belt which is created at the polar region, they are called as the thermal pressure belts. Why they are called as thermally induced pressure belt? Because these pressure belts are created due to the thermal difference. Thermal difference means what? Okay, now here there is a high temperature and here there is low temperature, and that is why here the temperature, here the low pressure belt is created. And at the equatorial region, sorry, at the polar region, the low pressure belts are created because the temperature is very low. So the pressure belts which are created at the polar region, that is at the north polar region and south polar region and equatorial region, they are called as thermally induced pressure belts, right? And the pressure belts which are created here, actually these pressure belts are created mechanically. Why these are created mechanically? Because you can see that when these pressures are moving from here to here, then here there is a creation of mechanical subtropical high pressure belt. This pressure belt is not created because of the temperature difference. This is created because when the wind is coming from this region to this region, when the wind is moving from this region to this region, it leads to subduction, and that is why here there is a creation of the mechanical subtropical high pressure belt, and here also we have a subpolar the low pressure belt. So these two, that is subtropical high pressure belt and subpolar low pressure belt in the north, and subtropical high pressure belt in the south. And the subpolar pressure belt in the south, both are mechanically induced. So there are total 4 mechanically induced pressure belt. One is at the north, subpolar pressure belt and subtropical high pressure belt, and south, subtropical high pressure belt and subpolar low pressure belt. So these 4 are mechanically induced pressure belts, while 3, that is one at the equatorial region, that is a low pressure belt, and at the polar region, this and north polar region and south polar region, these 3 pressure belts are of thermally induced pressure belt. So there are total 7 types of pressure belts are created over the surface of the earth. And these pressure belts leads to what you can say, the blowing of the winds. So here we can see in this region that the wind is blowing from subtropical high to equatorial low, subtropical high to equatorial low. So here from north to south and here from south to north. But when these winds are blowing, they tends to take a right direction in the north hemisphere and left direction in the south hemisphere. So here you can see the winds, although it is moving from this to this region, but what happens because of the rotation of the earth, right? You know what, the earth rotates, and the speed of the rotation of the earth is at 24 hours. In 24 hours, the earth, what you can say, completes one complete rotation. And because of this, what has happened? Suppose when the wind starts blowing from this region to this region, and because of the rotation of the earth rotates. So this part of the earth moves this region and the wind actually comes here. So actually it is not that the winds are not taking the right direction or the left direction. It is actually because of the rotation of the earth, it looks like the wind is taking right direction in the north hemisphere and left direction in the south hemisphere. So this particular effect of reflection or deflection of the wind to the right in the north hemisphere and to the left in the south hemisphere is called as Coriolis effect. So because of the Coriolis effect, the winds moves from east to west. So here we can see, depending upon the weather, whether the winds are blowing from east to west or west to east, depending upon the direction from where the winds are blowing, the winds are named as westerlies and easterlies. So can anybody tell me the winds which are blowing from subtropical high pressure to equatorial low pressure belts will be easterly wind sets or they will be westerly winds? Now here they will be blowing like that. They will be blowing from this to this direction. So I will play it again so you can come to know that the winds actually takes a right direction. So it will be coming from east to west, and here also east to west. So that is why These winds are called as easterly winds. Got it? Why they are called as easterly winds? Because they are coming from east direction. So the winds in the subtropical high pressure belt to equatorial low pressure belt, both in north hemisphere and south hemisphere, are easterly direction. But in here, but in this path, in this particular part, subtropical high pressure belt to subpolar low pressure belt, subtropical high pressure belt to subpolar low pressure belt, here the winds are blowing from this region to this region. Ye jahan se south se north honge aur yahan pe north se south honge. It will be exactly opposite because here the wind will blow from this region to this region. Am I right? Ye samajh mein aa raha hai? Why the wind will blow from this region to this region? All of you are understanding? Sonali?
Yes.
Okay. So here the wind will blow from south to north. So here the wind will take right direction. So it will move from this to this direction in this way, right? And here it will move from this to this. That is, it will take what you can say, the left, what you can say, the direction. And that is why it will become westerly. Got it? Westerly means what? When the winds are moving from west to east, they are called as westerlies. And when they are moving from east to west, they are called as easterly. So the name of the winds depends upon the direction from where they are coming, right? So I will play this video again, try to understand how the Coriolis effect decides the direction of the wind and how the pressure belt decides the wind will blow from which to which direction. So here you can see seven pressure belts are created. And because of these seven pressure belts, here you can see that here there is one pressure cell, here there is one pressure cell, and here there is pressure cell. So it is called as tricellular pressure belt model. Tricellular pressure belt model means what? Three cells of pressure belts and pressure winds are created. So here these, that from this to this region, and this to this region, and again polar region to subpolar low region. Right? So, and obviously, these winds plays a very, very important role on the human life, because these winds, what you can say, acts as a global heat exchange machine. How it will act as a global heat exchange machine? Because suppose when the winds are coming from this region to this region, it will reduce the temperature of the equatorial region. And when these winds are moving from this region to this region, it will increase the temperature of this region. Because here, the winds are moving from low temperature region to high temperature region. And here the winds are moving from high temperature region to low temperature region. So these will increase the temperature, while these winds will decrease the temperature. So in this way, these pressure belts and these winds act as the global heat exchange machine. Any doubts about it? Do you want to see this video once again so that you can understand it? Or otherwise, I will share the link on the group. You can watch it again and try to understand how the pressure belts are created and how the winds are taking right direction and left direction in North Hemisphere and South Hemisphere, which is called as Coriolis effect. Now, 1 minute is left. You have to join the session once again. Then we will go to the next point or the next topic. So meeting will end here. Please join again by using the same link.
Okay, sir.